Live from the zMAX drag strip at the Charlotte Motor Speedway in North Carolina, it's the 22nd annual Hooters International Pageant. Eighty of the most beautiful and brightest Hooters girls from around the world have come to Charlotte Motor Speedway, ready to make a dash for the sash, competing for the title of Miss Hooters International. It's a combo you don't want to miss, as they serve up a lot more than craveable dishes. Join us as they compete for the coveted title of Miss Hooters International. Now, let's meet your 22nd annual Hooters International Pageant contestants.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome your host. She's a former Miss Hooters International and Hooters calendar cover girl. And he's the co-host of the Covino and Rich Show on Sirius XM Radio's Faction Talk. Michelle Nunes and Rich Davis.
Wow.
Whoa.
Good evening, Charlotte. Look at this crowd. Woo. Welcome to the 22nd annual Miss Hooters International Swimsuit Pageant.
Charlotte, how you doing? What a crowd we have out here today, huh? We are ready. We are at the starting line and ready to wave that green flag, is that right?
Yeah.
On this year's competition.
Well done, Rich. And being that every second counts on this historic racetrack, why don't we let our lovely ladies head backstage to slip into their swimsuits?
Okay.
Thank you, ladies. There we go. Oh, you guys are in a good mood. I like this. And we're going to introduce to you the folks charged with the most enviable but difficult task of the night. Let's meet the judges.
Sounds good, Michelle. But our judges won't be the only one that have a say in this year's pageant. For the first time ever, you guys, the fans, are going to have a say in crowning the next Miss Hooters International 2018.
Yeah, did you guys hear that? You guys are our eighth judge.
That's a lot of pressure.
I know. You guys are going to be able to text your votes once we announce the top 10 finalists. So slow down on the selfies and save your battery life, and we'll get you more information later in the show.
Oh, crap. I'm at 60% already. Guys, save your battery life.
Yeah.
Slow down.
Airplane mode, whatever you got to do.
All right. But for now, let's introduce you to the rest of the folks making the tough decisions this evening. And there's nobody more qualified for the job than our first judge. She's a model. She's an actress, a TV personality. And in fact, people probably know her best as the face of Hooters. She was your first ever Hooters girl.
OG original.
The OG. Let's give it up for Lynn Austin. I'm going to go help her. I got to help. Lynn, let's go. Give it up, everybody, for Lynn. Your first ever Hooters girl. You're awesome, Lynn. Woo!
Oh, I like this. You guys are handing out swag as you walk? Yeah, you gotta walk Kim.
Oh, I'm sorry. I mean, come on, I'm sorry. Gentlemen, my bad. Let's
lay your coat down first. It rained earlier. Our next judge,
right.
You know, he may not know how to accessorize like tonight's contestants, but, you know, he still knows the value of a good belt.
Oh, I see what you did there, the belt thing.
Yeah.
Okay, gotcha.
He's a professional mixed martial artist competing in the UFC's light heavyweight division. Please give it up for Ovince St. Preux.
Ovince! Oh, he's looking slick.
You're looking sharp tonight, sir.
You need help down the stairs?
You should have gone to help him. Oh.
Give it up, guys, for Ovince.
He smells good, too.
Yeah. Is it weird to be like, what are you wearing, man? All right. You're going to know our next judge if you watch Bravo and you know Vanderpump Rules.
Yeah?
You do. You do. She's also a former Hooters girl from the great state of Kentucky. Please welcome Brittany Cartwright.
Where are you, Rich? Where are you?
I know. I got to do a better job. No problem. Brittany, everybody.
Rich, you're not sure what to do. Just go for it.
I know. I want to be helpful. I don't want to be a bad guy. Let me help you.
There we go.
There we go.
Get on over here.
All right, let's go.
Our next judge is also a popular face of Hooters. And while this may be our first time in Charlotte, this is certainly not his. You guys have any idea who it is? Maybe? He drives the Hooters Chevy Camaro ZL1.
You might know him?
Please welcome Chase Elliott, ladies and gentlemen!
Oh, hold on, hold on.
Yeah, go help him.
No, let me help you downstairs. Let me help Chase. Hey. Thank you, brother.
Looking sharp, too.
Chase Elliott, everybody. Oh, it's a heavy hitter panel of judges this year, huh? All right, up next, another regular here who can be heard on NASCAR's Glass Case of Emotion podcast.
Great name for a podcast.
It is. Give it up for the man behind the wheel of the number 12 Ford Fusion, NASCAR driver Ryan Blaney, everybody. Ryan, where you at? There he is, Ryan. There. Have fun, brother.
Staying with our NASCAR theme, she's also a host of NASCAR's Glass Case of Emotion, as well as being the social media reporter for the Motor Racing Network. Of course, you also may recognize her if you're a fan of The Bachelor.
I am. I watch The Bachelor.
I know you are. She previously held the title of Miss Sprint Cup. It is Kim Kuhn, ladies and gentlemen.
Kim! What's going on? I'm going to walk you down. This is a good job. And by the way, is throwing at a beer koozie the same as like a musician throwing at their guitar pick? I think so. Thank you, thank you. And last but certainly not least, where are my Carolina Panther fans at? We're in Carolina. Let's go. Now this dude, he plays defensive end. He has led the team in sacks for the last 2 years. I talked to him backstage. Hell of a guy. Mario Addison. Where you at, Mario?
Thank you.
you take your seat with the rest of the judges, we actually want to talk to you a little bit about an organization that I know is near and dear to your heart, as well as everyone at Hooters, and that's the USO.
Yeah, people might not know that Mario recently traveled overseas with the USO, along with other NFL players to visit soldiers who are currently stationed abroad. You got to tell us about your trip, man.
North Carolina, how y'all doing? How y'all doing? Okay, y'all doing good. Y'all doing good. But I got the luxury to go overseas two times, two tours, back to back, you know, to meet the soldiers and their families. And, you know, it's been a great experience for me. It's been a great experience, you know, to be able to meet the guys and their families. You know, it's outstanding. And their dedication, their attitude, every time I meet the guys, talk to them, you know, they got a special place in my heart. And, you know, anywhere they need me to go, I'm there. You know, they're here to protect us, you guys. They're here to protect us. So support the troops. Support the troops.
That's fantastic.
Thank you, Mario.
Thank you for your work with the USO. With that in mind, on this Memorial Day weekend, we want everyone to know that the USO has helped bring some very special audience members out here tonight.
Yeah, we've actually got a group of active military personnel with us this evening. Give it up. Now, any other veteran in the crowd, please stand up as well. Let's take
veterans
a moment.
Veterans back in the stands, please stand.
Please, let's take a moment to thank all these people for their service and let them know how much we appreciate what they do in protecting our freedom. Give it up.
And I won't forget the men who died, who gave that right to me. And I gladly stand up next to you and defend.
Thank you once again to Mario, the USO, and most of all to everyone who has served or is serving in the U.S. Armed Forces. Thank you so much.
All right, now, before we get this amazing pageant started, we just have one more little piece of business to take care of.
And to help with that, I want to bring out tonight's backstage correspondent, your 2016 Miss Hooters International, Sable Robert.
Oh, there you are, sneaking up on us.
Welcome, Sable. Look at this crowd.
I know. You guys look awesome.
Can you believe we're making history tonight with our first ever live crowd?
Oh, wow. Wait a minute, Michelle. I have to get a selfie.
I love this. Are you serious?
Yeah, I think she's serious.
Everyone?
Everybody squeeze in.
Squeeze in, everyone. Here, I'll take your mic. Get it ready.
We want as many people in this picture as possible, so squeeze in.
All
are you ready?
Smiles.
All right, wait, hold on. That guy blinked. Can we do this again? That guy right there. We okay? All right, one more time? Okay. Perfect.
We got it. It looks great.
All right, and Sable, before you head backstage to bring us off tonight's behind-the-scenes action, tell us where people can see this photo. Where are you putting all this stuff tonight?
I'm glad you asked. It'll be on, of course, the Hooters Instagram feed, our Facebook, Snapchat, Twitter,
okay.
And easy to find if you use that hashtag Hooters Pageant.
Nice, nice. Remember the hashtag Hooters Pageant tonight, and make sure every picture you post, you tag Michelle and I could use the followers.
Oh, Rich, that's so cute that you think that people are coming to see you versus those 80 beautiful women.
Yeah, hashtag Rich Davis. Let's do that tonight. But I get it. In addition to all these beautiful women, including both of you,
Thank you.
Know who you are here to see.
Who's that?
I'll give you a hint. Have you guys heard his hit American country love song as the women came out earlier? You know who I'm talking
These
about.
Guys have.
He's going to perform concerts all across the country. But tonight, live right here, we're talking about Jake Owen. A little later on tonight.
Wait a second. Like on this stage?
Oh, yeah.
Tonight?
Oh, you got it, pal.
Wait. Like a whole concert?
Yes.
For free?
Free. It's right. You guys are here free.
Okay. Well, let's get started then.
All right.
The next Miss Hooters International is chosen based on more than just her good looks.
Although those are pretty undeniable, but you're right. These are some pretty exceptionally accomplished Hooters girls competing for tonight's title.
That's right. It takes a philanthropic, you like that word? Spirit, intelligence, and of course, natural charm to earn this crown. So tell us, Sable, what is the energy going to be like backstage? You've been there, you've done that. What are you feeling tonight?
Well, people would probably be surprised to know that despite the intense competition, the girls are actually really supportive, and it's an awesome environment backstage.
I'm always amazed by that. They actually are friends. I'm like, there's no way they're friends. They all love each other.
Yeah, well, that's because they've been relying on each other all week long through all the busyness. So, of course, they had to rely on each other to get through this awesome week. Over the past few days, our Hooters girls have attended photo shoots, interviews, and special events that you'll hear about later tonight, all accumulating to last night's hometown pageant preview. But don't take my word for it. See for yourself. 2018 Miss Hooters International Pageant Behind the Scenes, take one. We're hanging out at the zMAX Dragway here in Concord, North Carolina. What do you think of our new pageant location?
One of the perks of pageant week is a photo shoot with the world-famous Hooters calendar. Let's check out what the Hooters girls look like in something different than orange shorts.
We all know Hooters girls are beautiful, but for pageant week, they get their own glam squad to help them look their best on stage. Check it out. So Jora, tell me what's your favorite part about pageant week?
Oh my gosh, media day is the funnest shoot yet. We get to show off our personality.
With the Hooters pageant open to the public for the first time, the Hooters girls are going RV to RV to get as many NASCAR fans in the crowd as possible. A lot going on here behind the scenes. The girls are actually rehearsing their opening dance number for the Miss Hooters International pageant. From the ballroom to the main stage, let's check out one of the final rehearsals. We're really behind the scenes now. The girls are here backstage at pre-pageant, ready to hit the stage. Lakin, how are you feeling?
I'm so excited and I can't wait to hit the stage.
The 2018 Miss Hooters International Pageant Behind the Scenes. That's a wrap!
I love the hometown pageant preview. It lets all the girls show off their creativity.
I agree. I had an amazing time.
Yeah, I saw you having an amazing time with that bottle of beach whiskey.
You mind your business. Each of tonight's contestants is an actual Hooters girl who comes to us representing the restaurant in their hometown, and not just across the United States of America. We're talking all around the world.
And tonight's top 10 finalists have already been chosen by our judges based on the activities that you guys just saw in the video. So the interviews, the photo shoots, and of course my favorite, last night's hometown pageant preview, which Rich does not remember.
Parts of.
So we'll announce the top 10 in just a bit so that you guys can make your picks.
Now, before we make those picks, you need to meet them, right? You want to meet the girls.
You guys want to meet them?
So let's do that now, starting with the first 40 beautiful women vying for the title of Miss Hooters International 2018.
Representing Addison, Texas, I am Heather Kirkendall.
Proudly representing Albany, New York, I am Ashley Oakenholm.
Representing Atizapan, Mexico, I am Gabriela Bustamante.
From Atlanta, Georgia, my name is Rachel Bodron.
Representing Atlantic City, New Jersey, I am Heather Bloch.
Proudly representing Augusta, Georgia, I am Taylor Driggers.
Proudly representing Bakersfield, California, I am Chanel Castro.
From Harvard Place Hooters in Baltimore, Maryland, I am Christina Reiner.
From Bossier City, Louisiana, I am Rachel Swartz.
My name is Gina Gribus, and I am proudly representing Champaign, Illinois.
My name is Rachel Ford, and I'm representing Charlotte, North Carolina.
Hooterifically representing Chesapeake, Virginia, I am Kazi Atha.
Honored to be representing Chicago, Illinois.
Clearwater, Florida, my name is Victoria Rosa.
Proudly representing Colorado Springs, I am Michaela Metcalf.
Happy to call Columbia, Missouri, my hometown, I am Paige Willits.
Proudly representing Concord, North Carolina, I am Treasure Morgan.
Representing Fairview Heights, Illinois, I am Amanda Steinbecker.
Proudly representing Farmingdale, New York, I am Katrina Aird.
Representing Fort Lauderdale, Florida, I am Jessica Nunez.
Haley Slobosian, representing Fort Myers, Florida.
Representing Fort Smith, Arkansas, I am Rebecca Hine.
Proudly representing Fort Worth, Texas, I am Sabrina Henson.
Proudly representing Frisco, Texas, I am Sabrina Martin.
From Pretoria in South Africa, my name is Richelle Flood.
From Grapevine, Texas, my name is Laura Castillo.
Proudly representing Greenville, South Carolina, I am Sydney Hickard.
Andrea Tamayo y represento Guatemala.
Proudly
done, ladies.
Wow.
You guys can take a walk off stage. We'll bring you guys. That was just the first half of our contestants of the evening.
And there's 40 more beautiful ladies coming to you from all over the world.
Are you guys ready to meet them, or should we just wait?
You guys ready? Do you already have favorites?
There's 40 more, so save some room.
Slow down.
Please welcome the rest of the ladies hoping to become the next Miss Hooters International.
Let's meet them.
Thank you. from Seabrook, Texas. I am Shelby Savoy.
Coming all the way from Seattle, Washington, I am Asia Tatum.
Representing Springfield, Missouri, I am Elizabeth Anthony.
Representing St. Louis, Missouri, I am Portia Malaya.
Proudly representing Sugarland, Texas, I am Taylor Gachera.
Happy birthday! It's me, it's nice to meet you. I am Nanako Kanda from Tokyo, Japan.
Toronto, Canada, I am Carrie Sadler.
Proudly representing Tucson, Arizona, I am Jennifer Koenig.
Proudly representing Tuscaloosa, Alabama, I am Simone Henderson.
Representing Wayne, New Jersey, I am Jasmine Smith.
Proudly representing Winston-Salem, North Carolina, I am Cassidy Craver.
Hey, another big round of applause for all of our contestants tonight. I know you have favorites now.
Yeah. They're all my favorites.
Are we ready to bring them all back on stage?
Let's do it. They're coming. While they're doing that, I think it's a good time to remind you guys to use that hashtag, the Hooters or Hooters Pageant, across all social media platforms to let people know that you're here tonight.
Yeah.
And let us know who you're rooting for.
You can also,
hashtag Hooters Pageant.
Yeah, you can also check out and retweet the selfie that Sable took with all of you. And don't forget, hashtag Rich Davis. So how are we feeling so far? We're loving this or what?
What about you guys? You guys are comfy. You're nice and seated back there. There we go. Someone's got a sign. I wonder what it says. I need my glasses. What? There's definitely some favorites happening.
You guys know your top 10? I hope so, because very soon, all of you will be acting as our eighth judge, texting your votes and helping in the process to find our next Miss Hooters International.
Yeah, we're going to give you guys, though, a little bit more time to think about it. We know it's an important decision. And while you guys are thinking, we're going to hand out a few special awards.
Oh, these are good. These are good.
They include Miss Photogenic, Miss Congeniality, and our Fan Favorite Award.
Yeah, that's the one that you guys have been voting on through social media the past week. That's the fan favorite.
Exactly.
Award.
Different than being our eighth judge tonight.
So, you guys ready to get started? Let's give away some prizes, starting with Miss Photogenic, who's going to walk home with $2,000. Also going to be whisked away. You like that?
Yes, very poetic.
To Clearwater, Florida, to take part in a photo shoot for a coveted spot in the 2019 Hooters calendar.
But before we crown a winner, let's take a look at the on-camera work that these Hooters girls have done over the past week.
We're up in North Carolina on Lake Norman shooting for the 2019 Hooters calendar, and there's 80 girls out here that are going to be representing Hooters in the 2018 International Pageant.
I believe the quality traits of Miss Photogenic is someone who exudes confidence and just an outgoing personality, someone that can have fun while taking pictures and at the same time be a role model for another girl.
Well, I get a little nervous, like anything, like this is a huge deal to be here shooting through the calendar, but I look at the picture and they do a great job, so they help us out so much.
If I were to win Miss Photogenic, I'd be over the moon. That's just something that is a dream of mine, and I never thought that I would see myself in that position, even to be competing for it.
To win Miss Congeniality, I think you have to have a really great personality, you have to be outgoing, and just a really nice person overall.
To be Miss Congeniality, I think you have to have a great combination of charisma, being kind, being helpful to all the other girls that are here, and just really rocking it and having fun and being that great ball of energy every single day to boost everybody up when it's late nights or 4 a.m. makeup meetings and sessions. It's that girl that kind of glues everybody together is what is Miss Congeniality.
It would mean a lot to me to win Miss Fan Favorite because I know that there's people out there that believe in me, like more than maybe just my mom.
What a week the ladies had, as you could see, huh?
Yeah. I think it's time to start giving out some awards, Rich. Where's that envelope?
I got it right here, everybody. You know what? I'm going to let you handle this.
Such a gentleman.
I know.
I mean, walking the ladies down the stairs.
I know.
And the winner of Miss Photogenic 2018 is from Louisville, Kentucky, Sydney Pickman, ladies and gentlemen.
Give it up. Congratulations.
Our next award is decided by our contestants themselves. The title of Miss Congeniality is awarded to the Hooters girl who best presents herself as a positive influence and cheerful example of the Hooters brand.
I'd say that title comes with a lot of bragging rights, but I feel like Miss Congeniality would be someone that wouldn't want to brag about that type
of thing.
I would
say you are correct, yes. But we are going to tempt her further because the title also comes with a cool $2,000 in cash.
Cool cash, cool cash. That's one heck of a tip. All right, our contestants have voted who they're loving. And the winner of Miss Congeniality is number 54 from New York, Francesca Peralta. Everyone loves you. Miss Congeniality, everybody. Congratulations.
Our next special category award of the evening, as I just mentioned, is decided by fans all over the world who voted on social media over the past several days.
These are the people that have been annoying their friends to go on Instagram and Twitter every minute.
Yes, it's our fan favorite award.
Exactly.
The winner of this year's fan favorite award, along with the cash prize of $2,000, is from Fort Myers, Florida, Haley Sablodzian!
Congratulations, ladies. Give it up. Now, tonight's contestants, as you've probably figured out, have come from all over the world. Literally, we have girls representing Hooters from South Africa to Japan and everywhere in between.
Even Costa Rica. Look at the flag up there.
What's up, Costa Rica?
Yeah, two flags. In fact, 9 of the contestants tonight are competing for this year's Miss World title.
Now, the title is also going to come with $5,000, and we'll let them worry about converting it to whatever currency they want, but it's $5,000 for Miss World.
Before we announce a winner, I want to check in with Sable Robert and hear from Miss World 2017. Sable?
Thanks, Michelle. One of the most prestigious awards we get to present tonight is Miss World. And I'm joined now by Miss World 2017, Hika Nakazawa from Tokyo, Japan. Hika, as we get ready to crown your successor, tell everybody, what does it take to make an amazing Hooters ambassador on the global stage?
I think Hooters Girls is always smiling and it makes happy and a powerful, cheerful, energetic. So I think they needed to be a good example of Hooters. They needed to be a good example
for Hooters.
For Hooters. And the, how much you love Hooters and the Hooters knowledge is very important.
Thanks, Hika. Now, let's learn more about the wonderful woman hoping to capture this year's title of Miss Hooters World.
Hi, my name is Nanako Kandas. I'm from Tokyo, Japan.
My name is Viridiana. I am from Mexico City, Mexico.
My name is Rochelle Floch, and I'm from Pretoria in South Africa.
Que mi nombre es Mariana Cibaja, vivo en Costa Rica, San José.
My name is Carrie Sadler from Toronto, Canada.
Hola, soy Gaby Bustamante de Atizapán, México.
I'm Taylor Lovegrove and I'm from Nottingham, England.
Me llamo Andrea Zamayoa y soy de Guatemala.
Hi, my name is Rosa. I am from Mexico City.
To me, winning Miss World would mean that I could have a lot more of an influence on other people to help their communities in the ways that I do.
Lo que espero yo es ganar nuevas experiencias. Yo nunca había concursado en un concurso así, en un evento así, menos en otro país. Y pues es eso, ganar nuevas experiencias, conocer a nuevas chicas y hacer buenas amistades.
Winning Miss World would be an amazing experience. It's something I never kind of imagined happening. Representing Canada is just such an amazing honor.
Bueno, significaría un privilegio enorme representar a la mujer, ¿verdad? Que Hooters te da esa oportunidad de representar mujeres trabajadoras, humildes, empoderadas. Y para mí sería ese gran privilegio y me siento preparada para lograrlo.
Pues mi mamá muy feliz, mi papá es ser expresivo, entonces tal vez me diría felicidades. Y mis amigos, pues igual orgullo.
My mum and dad are the most supportive parents. Like when I did the contest, they came with t-shirts made. So they would be happy whatever the result. But if I did take it home, they would be ecstatic.
Es un orgullo. La verdad no me lo esperaba, pero sí yo gané y quiero hacer lo mejor para representar mi país.
If I became Miss World, I want to visit different countries to make people aware of the beauty of the Japanese culture and history.
Para mí significa mucho, ya que es un país muy bonito, que tiene mucha cultura y que los invito a visitar.
I was an amazing year at Miss World, and many customers came to see me, and I made a lot of fans. The most memory is I went to New York for Hooters Girls signing event because I couldn't meet American customers and I had a good time, American beautiful Hooters Girl. I just want to say thank you so much.
Please welcome your contestants for Miss World 2018. From Atizapán, Mexico, Gabriela Patricia Bustamante Ruiz.
From Gauteng, South Africa, Rochelle Vlock.
From Guatemala, Guatemala, Andrea Samoya.
From Mexico City, Mexico, Shapiro Razo.
From Nottingham, England, Taylor Lovegrove. Wow.
From San Angel, Mexico City, Vera Blancas.
From San Jose, Costa Rica, Mariana Cibaja.
And from Tokyo, Japan, Nanako Kanda.
And last but not least, from Toronto, Canada, Carrie Sadler.
And now, please welcome Miss Hooters World 2017 from Tokyo, Japan, Hika Nakazawa.
Hika, in the Hooters tradition, I'd like you to take your final walk as Miss World 2017.
love it. Give it up for Hika, guys. You look amazing. Are you ready to name your successor?
Yes, I am. It's sad to be my at Miss World come to an end. It's been an honor to represent Hooters over the past year at Miss World and to bring the title back home to Tokyo. But whoever is Miss World 2018 will have an incredible year ahead. And I'm so excited to wish her the best.
Oh, you're amazing. Give it up one more time for Hika, guys. You're unbelievable. You want to announce the winner?
There we go.
I'm so nervous.
Yeah.
Okay. And the winner of Hooters Miss World 2018 is Mariana Sabana from Costa Rica!
Take her first walk as Miss Hooters World. Thank you, ladies. Congratulations, Mariana. Congratulations.
Thank you, ladies. You can exit. Thank you so much.
Wow. How great are the world's contestants, everybody? How great are they? I was terrible in Spanish in high school. Do you know how long she probably prepared? That's amazing.
I know.
All right, well, as we all know, Hooters takes pride in being more than just a restaurant. But a restaurant that cares about the community, both locally and nationally. And the women you're seeing here, they represent so strong. They actively promote this message every day wherever they go.
Yeah, they're never too busy to lend a hand. And actually, all 80 of tonight's contestants spent a good part of the week volunteering in the Charlotte community, visiting St. Jude Affiliate Clinic as part of Victory Junction's REACH program, as well as bringing care packages to Atrium Health Cancer Institute's breast cancer patients. And in fact, guys, Hooters has raised, are you ready for this? This blew my mind when I heard this number. Hooters has raised more than $5.3 million for breast cancer research.
Wow.
Right?
That's pretty amazing, right?
Give me goosebumps.
Whew. These Hooters girls go above and beyond, as you know. They also worked at the Second Harvest Food Bank at Metrolina here in Charlotte, putting together care packages for the USO of North Carolina. And I know Mario loves that. So take a look, everybody.
So I've always say that we come in as Hooters girls and we go out as one of the 350,000 women of Hooters, because that's what our alumni group is. So we decided to do some financial workshops, health workshops, social media workshops. I'm so excited for this next phase, for them to take home these skills, how to do a resume, how to do an interview.
I know a lot of the girls have reached out to me over the years since winning. Girls still send me their resume and ask me how to put Hooters on their resume for future jobs. And I always write back because girls did that for me who worked for Hooters before me. So I think it's super important to help and give my advice and my opinion to the other girls.
One of my favorite parts about Pageant Week is not only getting to meet so many awesome girls and creating those friendships, but it really is awesome to see that women empowerment in action. Every single girl is excited to be there. They're excited for their friends to do well. They keep encouraging everybody. I've always loved how involved in the community Hooters is and how much they promote that with the Hooters girls themselves. Not only do they take great care of the Hooters girls, but they really do so much beyond the store.
Our group went to the Second Harvest Food Bank, and we processed some of the donations into batches for different areas to drop off. So we went through medications and hygiene products and really helped sort through to make sure that they were getting the best of the donations. Last year, they gave out over 5 million pounds of food to people in need, which is an amazing service to the community.
This week, we had the opportunity to make goodie bags for the troops overseas and present them with a $5,000 check.
Hooters in the USO, North Carolina!
So while our group was preparing care packages for the USO, another group of girls had the opportunity to visit St. Jude's Children's Research Hospital in Charlotte, North Carolina. They created fun arts and crafts and activities for the children, as well as presenting a check for $5,000, which will go towards children's oncology research, as well as research for pediatric blood disorders.
Programs like ours run off donations, so I mean, what y'all do, we really, truly appreciate it. And know that it is touching the children and goes directly to them, so thank you.
It's such a good feeling knowing it's going to put a smile.
While you're here, while you're at the pageant, while you're at the children's hospital, while you're at the food bank, I think it's super important to just soak in everything, enjoy the moment, and kind of get away from everything else and just make sure you're given 110% when you're right there in the moment.
Some of our Hooters girls were able to present a $10,000 check to the Carolina healthcare system benefiting breast cancer research. They were also able to prepackage and deliver some comforting amenities to the patients.
And thanks to people like you who help us, thank you so much for this donation.
Thank you for having us.
To me, doing the charity work and being involved in the community is definitely what makes being a Hooters girl so special. You're so much more than a waitress. You really are making a difference in the world. And for the girls to be able to experience that, I think it's going to help out too with the stress of competition, is, you know, bringing yourself back down to that level and realizing why you love being a Hooters girl so much in the first place.
Welcome back. All right. Now, in addition to the efforts of all these amazing young ladies, Hooters has also made a donation to each of the charities they visited this week.
I mean, what an incredible group of women. I don't know how the judges are going to be able to pick a winner.
Agreed. I do not want to be in their shoes. Then again, I don't want to be in the shoes of the contestants.
I don't know. I think that you would look pretty good in a set of heels.
You think?
Yeah.
Thank you, Michelle. I think I'll leave that to the professionals. In any case, before we find out who's tonight's big winner,
we have to name tonight's top 10 finalists.
So, and let's get to that right now.
Yes.
Now, each of tonight's top 10 finalists, we're going to receive at least $2,000 in prize money. And one of these 10 women will be your next Miss Hooters International, which comes with a $30,000 cash prize.
Hey, you guys over there, remember to save your batteries, because as soon as we finish announcing the top 10, you will all be able to cast your vote for Miss Hooters International 2018.
Now here's where you guys become...
I was drinking during that 30-minute break, sorry.
Here's where you guys become the eighth judge. Get in on the action. You got to pay attention here. Pay attention. You're going to text Hooters space the contestant's number. So you're going to text Hooters space the contestant's number to 797979. One more time. Hooters space the contestant's number to 797979. All right.
Are you ready, ladies?
Oh, boy.
All right. In no particular order, our first finalist... Number 17, Trazia Morgan from Concord, North Carolina!
All right, our second finalist in the top 10. You guys ready? Number 22, Lakin Bumgarner. Douglasville, Georgia.
Finalist in the running to wear the crown of Miss Hooters International is from Orlando, Florida, McCalla Holloman. All the way in the back, here she comes, ladies and gentlemen. Remember, you'll be voting for your favorite of the top 10. So take note of their numbers.
Text Hooters space the number of your favorite contestant to 797979.
Voting is not open yet, so just get ready. Get the text ready.
All right.
And you got to see all the ladies in top 10.
The fourth contestant chosen to move on to the top 10 is from Miami, Florida, number 51, Allison Calderon.
All right, that's four down, six to go. So without further ado, congratulations to our next finalist from Downers Grove, Illinois, number 23, Alea Peterson.
Wow. Are some of your favorites making the top 10? All right, well, we got half to go.
We have five more.
Five spots remain, one of your final 10. From Schererville, Indiana. Number 69, Jura Stewart.
Again, these finalists are being called in no particular order and has no bearing on where they stand with the judges. Our next finalist to join them, from Las Vegas, Nevada, Hannah Williams, number 48.
Remember, you guys are our eighth judge, so pay attention. Pick your favorite lady from the top 10. Now,
remember
next up.
Remember her number. Remember her number.
Remember the number, 797979. Text that number, Hooters, space, the number of your favorite girl in the top 10. Joining these ladies in the top 10. Number 66, Mariana Cebaja from San Jose, Costa Rica.
Hey, wait. There's only two spots left. claiming the first of those from Nashville, Tennessee, Amberly Hall, number 53.
All right, in the final spot in this year's top 10, vying for that crown, Miss Hooters International 2018. From Boiser City, Louisiana, number 9, Rachel Schwartz. Charlotte, ladies and gentlemen, please show some love for your top 10 contestants for Miss Hooters International 2018.
Yeah, give it up for them.
I think we have some pretty amazing women in the final 10 here.
You know, just being chosen to come out here and represent my city amongst all these other girls, I feel like I've already made it. And then to advance even further and place top 10 amongst all these other girls, it's just something I can't even dream about doing, and I would just be forever grateful.
This is my first pageant ever, so I think being a part of top 10 and being called on stage like, hey, you made it to top 10, I would probably freak out, and I'm like overly excited. I'm here in my hometown, Concord, North Carolina, representing one of the best stores, and the drag strip is literally like 5 seconds down the road from us. So it's an amazing opportunity.
If I were to be in the top 10, I would probably lose my mind. It would mean so much to me. I feel like we work so hard. All these ladies do great. It's so hard for the judges just to pick 10 and pick 5 and pick 1. But I would probably lose my mind.
Placing is just one step closer, but it's still, it doesn't compare to the week long that you have with these girls. It doesn't compare to everything you get to do beforehand, before the pageant, is what really, really, really makes this an experience that's so memorable.
If I were to make it into the top 10, it would be such a victory for myself and especially my city. The city of Las Vegas, we had a really hard year this year, and we became stronger, and I've witnessed such an incredible and phenomenal bonding to add to the triumph and the regaining of power. That would just be so amazing to bring a title like that back to Las Vegas.
Bueno, salir en las 10 últimas finalistas sería un gran orgullo. Me sentiría increíblemente feliz de darme cuenta que pudieron observar los jueces carisma, personalidad para llegar a esa posición.
I did the math, and we are, us 80 girls are in the top 002 percentile of our Hooters girls. To make it even farther is, I can't do the math, but it's really cool.
If I were to win Miss Hooters International, it would be a dream come true. Working and putting in all the work to get this far is such an accomplishment, and to show girls that hard work pays off and that you can make your dreams a reality would be the greatest feeling ever.
Wow, to be in the top 10 would be nerve-wracking but so exciting. It's so many beautiful girls from all over the world, and it would just be an honor to represent my store.
This is such an intense competition, but we're having so much fun. And it's not just the people outside of Hooters, the incredible people that are gonna be in the crowd and watching us and yelling and supporting, but the support that I've gotten from the other girls on stage. It's appreciated, it's wonderful, and I'm so excited to be here.
My favorite thing about Hooters is that they definitely let everyone be themselves, and they embrace that. I would just like people to know that I truly care. Today's customer is tomorrow's regular, and with Hooters, we treat every guest like they're a regular.
Muchos de nuestros clientes, cada persona tiene su historia de vida. Hay historias de vida que son más complicadas que otras. Y muchos de ellos y de ellas llegan a Hooters porque se sienten en un lugar donde pueden conversar, donde pueden divertirse, donde pueden olvidar sus problemas.
I go to work and I am hanging out with my best friends. That's something that you can't find in another workplace. You're surrounded by girls that love you. You're surrounded by a support system. It's your family.
We are all unique. We are all beautiful in our own way. And we just need to own that. And that's one of the greatest things about working for Hooters for me, is that I can be myself. I can be the girl that wants to walk across the stage in the pretty dress.
Like, there's so many encouraging women that we work with, and they inspire you to do better. Like, I love all the girls that I work with. We will be best friends forever, and I just want everybody else to know that walking into Hooters, like, you're always gonna be loved.
It's time to turn the pressure up even higher on you amazing judges, because you're the ones that have the difficult task of narrowing this field of 10 down to the final five.
And ultimately picking a winner.
You got it, pal. All right, so while you guys cast your votes, let's get some insight on how you guys are going to be making your decisions. Let's start with Brittany Cartwright.
Rich, if you keep taking my lines, how much whiskey did you drink back there?
I'm a huge Vanderpump Rules
fan. This is not the pre-pageant. Stay with me tonight.
Okay.
All right, Brittany, you were a Hooters girl, so you know what it's like to represent the company. What are the qualities that you're looking for in tonight's Miss Hooters?
Just confidence and poise and just owning the stage. I think it's very important in a Hooters girl to be able to own the room and be able to talk to so many people. So confidence is definitely key.
Okay. Now
let's hear it from the guys.
Where do you want to go? Chase, how about you, buddy? I mean, obviously you're doing a different job than your day job, driving a race car, but you're all about representing the Hooters brand. So what makes these women stand out? What are you looking at?
Well, a lot of different things, actually. Here we go. Everybody give it up for these lovely ladies tonight. There we go. I'm looking for a lot of things. You know, I think, obviously, you know, a girl who can own the stage, that's very important, for sure. But somebody that's real and can hold a good conversation with you is pretty important, too. So, I'm on the hunt for a lot of good things. I'm a pretty strict judge, so we'll see.
Wow.
All right, thank you.
I'm kind of scared.
Thank you, judges. I know you have a hard job right now. I don't envy you at all, except for maybe the NFL and race car money. I envy that. All right, let's check back in with Sable. We're about to take the final 10 down to the final 5. Sable, what's going on back there? What's the vibe?
You know, it's a little crazy back here, so we just got to go with the flow. But you know what? I probably have one of the best seats in the house. And I'm not going to lie, being backstage is making me miss being a contestant in these awesome Miss Hooters International pageants. These girls have been working so hard prepping all week and even longer. And I'm ready to find out the results. I know the girls are ready to find out the results. What about the crowd? Are you guys ready? Now back to you, Michelle and Rich.
We're getting even closer to the moment of truth. Our judges and all of you guys who decided to vote, I think have narrowed it down to the final five.
Yeah. You guys feel like you know who's winning this thing?
Oh, I see it. Wait, can I say it?
Yes.
Can I say it?
Say it.
Can we have the envelope, please?
Oh, I love that.
Yes.
Thank you so much. Wow.
Come with me. Come with me. We're going over here.
Let's go. By the way, who do you think's winning? What are we thinking? Any one of these girls could be your next Miss Hooters International 2018. The first finalist, moving on to the top five, is...
Guys, we got our top 10. Root for them now.
Number 22, Lakin Bumgardner. From Douglasville, Georgia.
Our second Hooters girl advancing to the top five is... Number 9, Rachel Swartz from Bossier City, Louisiana.
The third finalist, guys, getting one step closer to that $30,000. Number 17, Treja Morgan.
Two spots remain, one to be filled by. What's that? From Las Vegas, Nevada, number 48, Hannah Williams.
Taking that final spot in the final five, your top five for the 2018 Miss Hooters International is number 53, Amberlee Hall, Nashville, Tennessee.
Congratulations to all of you for making it to this part of the pageant. And congratulations to everyone participating in this year's show. Just getting to Charlotte to represent your Hooters is a huge accomplishment. You guys are the best of the best.
I wish we could say the hard part is over for the judges, but it's not. They have their questions ready to go. Judges, you're ready, right?
Yes.
All right.
All right, fantastic. Now, to level the playing field, our judges have drawn a contestant's number out of a hat. So there's no bias in who answers each of the judges' questions. We're going to go in the order which Rich and I announced your guys' names. I think
by the way,
actually,
what hat? Let's go up here. What hat are they picking these out of?
I don't know. Chase's helmet.
Okay, Chase's helmet. Fine. Okay.
Then, actually, before we start, I want to ask you. I mean, you're the OG Hooters girl. You've been to more than a few of these pageants. How important is the question round?
It's very important. I am looking for quick wits and class and, of course, intelligence. And charm and beauty.
Let's switch. All of the whole package.
No pressure, girls.
Yeah.
No pressure.
I'm so glad I did not have a question wrong my year. Oh, Vince, why don't you start us off and ask question number one to our first finalist? Why don't you join us?
Lakin, come on up. Ovince has your question.
Hi, Ovince.
How you doing?
Good.
Where do you see areas of improvement as a in a country as a whole?
Can you repeat the question one more time?
Where do you see areas of improvement in our country as a whole?
Powerful women, 100%. Every single day, women are only getting more empowered by our sisters. I mean, look at these girls. These girls are the reason that I'm here right now. They are my support system. Hooters is my support system. And Hooters has taught me that the one thing that goes into this world that is kindness, and what goes around comes around. And these girls and every Hooters girls I've ever met are only encouraging people to be better, are only encouraging women to be more individualistic, more empowered, more intelligent, and go for what they want. And that's something that's really important to me, and that's something I feel like the world is really improving on.
Wow.
Nice, thank you.
Thank you, Lakin. Number 22, Lakin. All right. Brittany, ready to Vanderpump this up? Here we go. You got contestant number two. Come on out here, Rachel.
Finalist number two.
Here we go. Rachel, your question is from Brittany.
Hi. If you win this pageant, how would you use your title to benefit others?
If I won Miss Hooters International, I would use this title as a platform to be an ambassador for positivity. We are here to lift up each other and set positive examples for those around us and to leave the best mark on the world that we can.
There you
go. Nice.
There you go. Thank you, Rachel.
Thanks, Rachel. All right, Chase, the floor is yours. We're going to bring up our third finalist, Trazia Morgan, contestant number 17. Chase, are you ready?
Hi.
If you could interview anyone in the world, whom would you choose to interview, and what would you ask them?
If I could choose anybody in the world to interview,
I would probably choose somebody from our past and our history as Abraham Lincoln. I feel that he is somebody to look up to, always being honest. That was his main thing, never tell a lie. And I believe honesty gets you so far in this world. I mean, without honesty, what do you have? You don't have anything. So I feel that if I could interview anybody, it would definitely be Abraham Lincoln, because he is such an idol for all of us.
Well, thank you.
And he wore an amazing hat. He had a great hat. We should have chosen numbers out of Abe Lincoln's hat tonight.
Yeah, or you could have just worn Abe Lincoln's hat.
Next year, Abe Lincoln's hat. All right, let's bring up our next finalist. Hannah, Ryan, you got the floor, my man.
Hello, Hannah.
Hi, good evening.
What is your opinion on the treatment of women in the workforce?
Oh, is this a tough question? Mm-mm-mm. Well, let's see how she's going to do.
Thank you, by the way. My opinion on women in the workforce is I think that this is an absolutely monumental time to be a woman in the workforce. I think that women right now in 2018, we hold so much power. We are 47% of the workforce. And not only that, but as natural givers and caretakers and just naturally empathetic beings, we certainly have a lot to contribute to any business that we may so choose. And I definitely am excited to see where the future takes women. I'm excited to see what the world will be like for my daughter. And I cannot wait to just witness this wonderful evolution of women being empowered and women being more present in the workforce and leadership roles and just everywhere you turn around. Thank you.
Wow.
All right, Kim, we're gonna give you the final question to Amberly Hall of Nashville, Tennessee. Come on up here, girl.
Amberly.
Hi, Amberly.
Hi, beautiful.
What accomplishment are you most proud of from the past year and why?
The accomplishment that I'm most proud of from the past year is learning to accept my faults, accept my failures, and know that it's just making me a better person. I have grown so much in the last year, in my career, in my personal life as a woman, and I have never in my 27 years on earth felt more confident or more ready to take on the world than I do today. So if there's the one thing I'm most proud of, it's just accepting me for me.
Thank you.
All right, I want to remind you guys again, the contestants' numbers, because remember, you have the opportunity to help out here. Number 22, Lakin. Number 9, Rachel. 17, Treja. 48, Hannah. And Amberly, number 53, all right?
Wow. Thank you, ladies. Let's hear it for our top five, ladies and gentlemen. I mean, whoa, these answers, right?
Did you just give us a Joey Lawrence, whoa?
Yeah, I kind of
did. Give us
I'm just very excited.
Or is it more of a Keanu, whoa?
No, I think more of the Joey Lawrence, yeah. All right, I think it's almost time to crown Miss Hooters International. And then I think someone's going to be performing on stage. Who is it?
Oh, someone
yes!
named Jake
say
Owen.
Say it again. Jake Owen, ladies and gentlemen, is going to be on the stage after we crown Miss Hooters International 2018.
Can't wait. Let's kick it back to Sable. What's going on, Sable?
Hey, everyone. I'm backstage again, but this time with the current Miss Hooters International 2017, Chelsea Morganson from Hollywood, California. Chelsea, as a former Miss Hooters International, I kind of know what you're going through, but for everybody else, tell us, what will you take away from your experience as Miss Hooters International?
Honestly, this year has taught me so much that I will never forget. I'll never take anything for granted for the rest of my life. I made appearances with little kids that taught me so many valuable lessons, and I'll never forget it.
Is there anything you're going to miss the most about this year?
Probably the free chicken wings. No, but honestly, I'm going to miss meeting all the beautiful girls from all over the country and all over the world, but I never miss a chance to stop into the local Hooters anywhere I go, so I'll be good.
Well, Chelsea, you've been amazing. Now, let's take one more look back at your year as our reigning Miss Hooters International.
So this year, as Miss Hooters International, I was able to travel to over 75 Hooters stores, which was really exciting for our calendar signings. And I met, hundreds of Hooters girls at every single place that I went to. Everyone was just so welcoming everywhere that I went, and it was just really empowering to me to see all these other girls lifting everyone up, complimenting each other, and just kind of being there for each other. It was really cool, and I kind of felt like family everywhere that I went. One thing that was really close to my heart that I did this year was I had the opportunity to go with a few other Hooters girls to do the Kiss Cares for Kids Radiothon at the Joe DiMaggio Children's Hospital over in Florida. That was probably one of the most inspiring things for me to do this year. There was a little girl, and she had gone through cancer already a few times. She was only, 7 years old. It made me kind of sit back and think, if this little girl can fight cancer multiple times and still have that kind of outlook on life and still have that kind of attitude, then we should be able to be happy with what we have, and we really shouldn't take anything for granted. Unfortunately, I lost my grandmother to cancer right before Pageant last year. And I don't know if you know, any of you noticed, but there's one picture that I absolutely fell in love with, and I started bawling when I saw it. But after I won, she was the first person that I thought about, and so I blew her a kiss, and they caught that moment. And I'm so, so happy, because that was just such a special moment for me, and I get to treasure that forever. I just want to say thank you to Hooters for giving me this opportunity of a lifetime. I would not be the woman that I am today if it wasn't for this company and for this last year. And I want to say thank you to my family. I hope that I made you all proud.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Miss Hooters International 2017, Chelsea Morganson.
Chelsea.
Hey.
How are you feeling tonight?
Hello.
It's bittersweet. Yeah. I've had a blast this last year, but I'm so excited to see who gets to fill my shoes and take on this year.
If you had a piece of advice for the Miss Hooters that's going to win this year, what would it be?
Take every opportunity and live this next year to its fullest. Don't say no to anything that comes your way. And just really soak it all in.
It goes fast.
Time flies.
You know what time it is, right? Before we crown your successor, it is time for you to take your final walk as Miss Hooters International. With you yet.
You made it a whole year.
I know it's bittersweet to take that final walk, but you're now part of the Hooters family, so we know you'll continue to be an amazing ambassador for Hooters, as well as a role model for young women around the world. Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, you're welcome.
All right, and with that said, it's time to learn our judge's final decision. Is everyone here in Charlotte ready to crown the next Miss Hooters International? You guys ready? Ladies, are you ready?
I'm ready.
All right, I think you say it this time.
Here we go. Can I have the envelope, please? Thank you. This year's fourth runner-up is going to take home a cash prize of $5,000. The fourth runner-up, number 17, Treja Morgan. Give it up, everybody, for Treja. Fourth runner-up.
Next, our third runner-up, who will earn a cash prize of $6,500. She is in fourth place, and it is from Nashville, Tennessee, number 53, Amberly Hall.
We're getting close. Make some noise, Charlotte. Our next contestant is going to earn a cash prize of $8,000. Your second runner-up is number 48, Hannah Williams from Las Vegas, Nevada.
Okay, it's two contestants left, and it all comes down to this.
Now remember, everybody, the runner-up is gonna get $10,000, all right? So the runner-up walks away with 10 grand. Are you ready? By the way, you ready, Charlotte? Let's do this, Michelle, all you, let's go.
The winner of the 22nd annual Hooters International Swimsuit Pageant is... from Douglasville, Georgia, Lincoln Bogartner!
Wow!
Woo!
What? Give it up for Lincoln, everybody!
Miss Hooters International 2018. It's almost time.
Are you
for
ready?
You to take your first walk as Miss Hooters International. Congratulations to all the women tonight who made it to our stage. I hope their stories inspire young ladies around the world and make their dreams come true.
Thank you for joining us for the 22nd annual Miss Hooters International pageant. And congratulations again to tonight's winners. Miss Photogenic, Sydney Pinkman. Miss Congeniality, Francesca Peralta. Miss Fan Favorite, Haley Schlobojan. Miss World from Costa Rica, Mariana Sabaja. And of course, a congratulations to your runner-up, Rachel Schwartz. And last but not least, your new 2018 Miss Hooters International, Lincoln Bumgardner. Give it up, Charlotte.
Thank you, judges. Thank you, Sable, for working it backstage.
And everyone here in Charlotte, thank you so much. And NASCAR for making us feel like a part of your big family.
I'm Michelle Nunes.
I'm Rich Davis. And on behalf of everyone at the 22nd annual Hooters International Pageant, thank you so much for joining us tonight.